Kicking off in just a moment, because apparently I hate myself. If you are here early, sound off, you naughty little trumpet. Hello. Hello and welcome to I'm going to play this game that makes me poo. I'm wearing a nappy.
Are you? Full title. Didn't want to type that all out.
Also, Minnie's in the room with me. Aren't you, Minnie, eh? Hello. My dog's in here too. So, behave you lot, okay?
We're going to carry on with some little nightmares. Why? Because I don't want to sleep comfortably anymore. So here we go. This is Big Damn Play. If you're watching this live, keep in mind it will be up for a while. People will be able to watch it into the future. So if you don't want to have anything particularly personal being spoken about, don't bring it up, because folks are going to know about it. Also, it's warm. It is very, very warm right now. So I have, like, nothing in my hair. So as to not make my scalp suffer, I have not much on below the waist, so you're going to be getting any elaborate song and dance sequences this week, I'll tell you that for now. How are we all doing? Ah, Tarsia, must you play with my mind and brain? Ooh, also, I have a coal can, so I should probably open it. Not beer, if you're watching last night's Fortnite stream. I had to down that second can before I went to sleep. I didn't have that much in my tummy, so by the time I was in bed, like 10 minutes later, I was half cut. So that was fun. Okay. I think I've scared everyone away with that. With what, the pants part, probably. Also, it's midday and people are watching other stuff. Which is why we shall resume. Pior favor. The office a bit of a dust. The monitor's got a tiny little film of specks on top of it. So let me remember the controls. So R2 is grab, L2 is crouch, square is run, X is jump, and circle is lighter. Okay. Okay. I can remember these things, I think. I don't know. We shall see. We shall see. Oh, it's so creepy that every time you resume, you're like in the fetal position, freaking out. Okay, come on, little protagonist, you can do it. Oh, and I've got to keep hold of R2 while you climb. Okay. Come on, little protagonist, by the way, if you could host a stream, I'd greatly appreciate it. Spread the word, spread the love.
And that's why heaven is full of angels.
Thank you so much, Jihad. Welcome, Abiohod. Here we go. Oh, that poor bag. Okay, here we go. So, from what we saw from the janitory dude with the long arms, these are other children. Oh, there's a chef up there. That's a guy in a chef's hat. Ew, no, 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 no. So, there's other children, presumably dead. Oh, larger bags. Larger bags. Okay, how big are we talking in terms of humans? Oh no, she's hungry. She needs food. She needs a few heads. Meats. Or otherwise. Boo, are you there? Our protagonist needs meats. Could you get us some meats? No? Oh, okay, fair enough. All out of meats. What about children turned to stone that could be packaged like meat? Right, stop. You're working on it. Okay, no worries. How was the big damn recording? That was yesterday morning. It was good. It was very good. We had a giggle. Good episode this week. A lot of stuff to react to. We were going for the looser format this week, but we ended up with content. So, pardon? Some meat. Yeah, some children meat. Oh, that's a mouse trap. Oh, can we grab it? No, so we just need to avoid it. Okay. Oh, God. I have a feeling I know what's going to happen. There's going to be a freaking meat. Piece of meat on a mousetrap. Oh, no, it's not going to make us eat this rat, is it? No. Oh, no. Did we save it? Oh! Okay, I pulled the rat to save it, but we're eating the rat. Okay. Okay, that's a thing that happened. We just ate a rat that was alive. But it was dying, so is it a mercy kill? Oh, that's horrible. That's horrible. I didn't want this. I didn't want this. I didn't want this. Thanks, tiny little protagonist. We thought you were cute. You're just eating a rat. Welcome back to Little Nightmares, everyone. Damn right. Oh, God. Oh, good Lord. This is just the worst, and I love it. Alright, is there something down here? There seems to be a lot of, awful lot of crevices. No. Just double checking that we're not missing any of the statues. Keep forgetting you have to press R2 whenever you want to climb so much. She doesn't always climb it immediately. Mr. Rat, why? Why did we have to eat Mr. Rat? Oh! That wasn't meant to happen. I was just looking for a crevice. Oh, I'm glad we did it. Look. Geisha statue and also a statue. Oh. It's like a full-on shrine. This is new. It's a shame we can't, like, read the letters or whatever. So there's a shrine to this geisha. And there's a painting of a young woman facing away from the artist. Oh, this is... Okay. This is new. Wasn't expecting this. But I'll take it. Are we meant to find that? No, not necessarily. Okay. I'm glad we looked. He says, walking to the door with blood at the bottom of it. Oh, kitchen doors. And there was that big chef guy. There was that big dirty chef boy. And there's blood all up the wall. So we need to get through that hatch. Ah, you've been planting up, have you, Ian? Making more plants. So you can feed them to your rats, so they eat the rats. Wait, what? Can you all hear a knife? I can hear a knife. I don't want to hear a knife. Can we walk through here? No! Oh, I don't need that in my life. Oh, I don't need that in my life or in my existence. Oh, that's horrible. And this one's got eyes. Can it get me once I'm hidden? It can. Don't you dare throw me in the pot. Oh, it's going to cut me up. Fantastic. Okay, so we have to sneak past Giant Chef Boy. Brilliant. Stuart, thank you so much for the host. Welcome aboard. Okay. Already stressing. Already stressing. Already stressing out. Okay. Okay. See, if I knew how to use a heart rate monitor, we'd be playing this with a heart rate monitor. Wait till he gets to the stove. Go to the stove, creepy man. Oh. Oh, good lord. There's a little hatch there. We could go that way. Only when we know he's not looking. So when he goes back over to the... Oh, he's got like a gaping mouth. Oh no, not the gnomes! It heard the gnomes. It's coming for the gnomes. Oh god. No, I don't like it. He just grabbed a sausage. Come on. Let's hide under there. Oof. Oh, there's a bunch of gnome folks as well. Did he see me? Ugh. Oh, he's rubbing his face up against the fish. That's horrifying. Don't need that in my life, thank you very much. Oh god. I hate this, I hate this, I hate this, I hate this, I hate this so much. Ugh. Get under the table. Oof. Oh! You look so greasy! Who's he cooking for? That's what I want to know. Who's he cooking for? There's so many dead people. We've had dead children. He seems to mostly be working with fish and sausages. But still, who's he making meats for? Who is this man making meats for? He's salting the fish. Ooh, even the oven looks like the mouth of a fish. Looks like his mouth. Ugh. How am I going to escape the grease man? Very good question. Because he's on my tail at the minute. Oof. Oh, God. Does he know I'm up here? Oh, God. Oh, this is horrifying. This is the worst. Oh, which way should we go? Well, that's got a beam, so that's not going to help anyone. Let's go this way. Oh, it's horrible. I'm going to go right first because I want to see what's over here. Nothing, just breads. Just breads, ladies and gents, just breads. Because you'd think we'd go that way to get out of the room, but there must be something over here. Oh, God. Freaking out. Hey, Addit, welcome aboard. Don't forget to drop us a host, dear boy. Look at this. Ugh. God, this is horrible. I love it. I'm so glad I bought this. It's the worst. It's so creepy. Oh, God. For those who are wondering, the reason why we've gone for Little Nightmares is because the other day from a new show, Games Vault, which you can find more information out about if you type exclamation mark Games Vault, is one word, I interviewed Andreas Johnson, the head of Tarsia Studios, the people who made this game. And as soon as I saw that it was on sale, I was like, yep. Yep. Sign me the feck up. This is horrible. I bet there's a trophy for doing all the candles. There's a photograph up there of a shriveled lady face. Mrs. Ladybird face. Yada! Afternoon! Thank you for the resub yesterday, by the way. Very much appreciated. Hope you're doing well. Hey, little gnome. There's a door there. And the gnome suggests there are adventures to be had this way. But what's with the door? Was this a bad decision? Should we have gone the other way first? Ah, welcome. Welcome to Team Bluetooth. It's good to have you aboard. Hang on. No! It took us back downstairs! Oh, then again, maybe you need to do that. Maybe it's because we need to come back down later. So we've got to go in that room first, I guess. Right, so we need to head back upstairs. Oh, this is horrible. Oh, this is horrible. Come and get me, big boy. Greasy McGee. Oh. he's too bent down for the one called the Grease Man. God, he's horrible. If you had the music that accompanies him, it's gross, isn't it? Ah, and he's got hay fever too. Alright, I feel for him now. I sympathise with him. No! Shit! What did we learn? Don't jump. God damn it.
Hello, it's me, the Greaseman.
Is what you could say. No! Idiot. Wrong button. Yeah, the buttons are a little tricky because they're all mostly gravitating on the right side of the pad.
And that's why heaven is full of angels.
Press. Steph, thank you so much for the host, my lovely. Hope you're doing well. Everybody's joined, by the way. Hello, how you doing? Welcome to Big Damn Play. Let's keep things fun. Let's have a giggle. I'm playing Little Nightmares, so it's important that we have fun while I lose my damn mind and scream a lot. Go on, up we go. Let's avoid the Grease Man. Please to bend down for the one called the Grease Man. He's a greasy little shit. Hang on, we've got to turn the candle on again. Turn the candle on. Jesus. Light the candle, you dork. Right, here we go. Here we go, boys. So don't go in that. That's the elevator that takes us back downstairs to Greasy McGee. All we can hear is music. Can you hear it? What's in this room? Oh! There's something on the bed. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. I don't want this. I don't want this. What is it, and can I avoid it forever? Wait, is it the same chef? Oh God. There are two of them? Oh, he's the worst. Look at him. No! Oh my God. So I think we need to get the key, then immediately hide. Not the key off, then immediately hide, and then when he's gone back to bed, get the key. Ooh. Tweedledee and Tweedledum. Yes! Those are the vibes. Those are the vibes. Ian in chat says, I should have asked yesterday how many in chat have played Bioshock, seen someone play Bioshock. I've watched my wife play Bioshock many a time. I've never played it myself. It would make me poo. I'm bad at first-person stuff in general. Like, you see how I barely get by on things like Overwatch and whatnot. Imagine a whole game, but a horror game set underwater. Too much for me. Come on, wiggle your little legs. Right, so get into the bed. Oof. So can you hear in the music? You know you're nearer to him when you can hear the tune. So is this key for that door? I guess not. I'm not terrible at Mario Kart. But I'm more a Crash Team Racing guy when it comes to the novelty carts. Which I think we should do as a big damn play, because there is a story mode. And I do love playing it. Here we go. So what is this the key to? And are we gonna have to drop it a fair few times before we can use it? I've just realised what's happening. There's two of them. So now there's going to be one in this side of the room and one in the other side of the room. And I'm going to have to eat some crisps to get over this because mentally I don't think I can deal with it. So I'm going to have a crisp. My dad and stepmom randomly brought me these the other week. M&S Habanero Hot Wings Ridge Cut Crisps. Sizzling chicken flavour with a fiery habanero chili marinade. And I was like, really? Is that gonna work? They do. They really do work. Hmm. Not sponsored, but if they'd like to. You can't hear the music very well because you can't plug your headphones into your laptop. Right. Probably for the best. Because when we get closer to them, any of them, you can hear that subtle in the soundtrack. Ah, Greaseman. Our natural state first thing in the day. Please to bend down for the one called the Greaseman. He wants to make you his bride. Okay. I have a feeling this is going to be very trial and error. Gods, we know he can see us from here. So everyone who's just tuned out, don't blame you. This is horrible. He looks like me, 23-6. He hasn't found us, has he? Sausage. Guess we can't get up there. Oh god. Hey Richard! The meats, exactly. We found the meats. Can't open the door. Ah! This is why. Oh god, here we go. Oh, presumably we have to put some meats in a meat thing. Or not. It's just set dressing. Oh. Oh, there's some meat production involved. Oh, we need to make a string of them. Or not. Wait a minute. Could we push it the other way? No. So there's no meats left, so we need more meats! Oh! Nope. Pick up the meats! This is the worst. I love it. Okay, so it's not that. Oh. Okay. Where is the meat coming from? A very, very good question at this point, Ian. Well, we saw these bags earlier, didn't we? When we first saw these bags, they were full of children. The guy with the creepy arms was packaging up the, like, the petrified children into the bags. Chances are we're going to have to go up there at some point, aren't we? Oh, God. Ah, so we'd have to go up here several times unless we can get it all now. I'm assuming those two are the ones we need. Come on, get the meat onto the trapdoor. The meat door, if you will. And I'd rather not, because, ugh. Okay, so that's two slabs of meat. Let's go back downstairs. This is horrible, isn't it? Who's having lunch right now?
Ah, the meat door. The door for meats. I wonder if there's any lamb.
Alright, here we go. And they both go. Yeah, we woke up late, so it was cereal for me today. These crisps, but we're having a spag bol a bit early later. Leftover spag bol. All that, so we could do this.
Ah, lovely, the meat.
Grotesque. Absolutely grotesque. So was it the same chef, or are there two of them? Is it a Tweedledee Tweedledum situation? Angel! Hello, lovely! Mm-mm-mm. I'm shitting myself. How are you? Yeah, that's not movable. Imagine if you made that jump. It didn't make the jump, but we had to make more meat. Two beds, two pictures. That's a very good point. At least the bags aren't wiggling around anymore. That was disturbing before, wasn't it? Okay, so we need a key. Cue Ian with the Haunted Mansion movie quote. To go. Are you okay?
Where are we meant to meet?
Fair enough. Just like, yeah, I could pay attention to you, but I'm going to watch you play Little Nightmares. Hey, if it helps you. Right.
Get in there.
Oh. Oh, this one's got a flatter face. The other one's that weird fish mouth. So it's aware of our existence. I suggest that it's going to come find us.
Oh god.
It's going to drop the thing it put in its pocket and we'll be able to use that to open the switch. Or not. No, okay. It's opened the door for us. Oh fuck, here we go. I really don't want to do this. Good lord. Nope. Nope. Do we dare walk around it? Say what, Angel, this game is the ultimate, like, hands face space. So I don't want to go anywhere near these guys. Oh god. Jord, how can you be hungry at a time like this? Is there a way out? No. I don't get it. Oh, key! Well, that was pretty successful. Come on, do the animation. Did it spot us? I'm shitting myself. This is horrible. I love it. Something here we can use. Yay! Knew it! My god, these crisps are really nice. A little bit spicy. So, let's top up now. Now, really quickly, I'm going to wash my greasy ass. Hand.
I just need to whirl.
Oh. Like, they're nice, but they're very greasy. So I didn't want to, you know, be rubbing the controller with my greasy pips. As one does. Ah, hope we're all doing well. This is pretty stressy, I'm not going to lie. What flavour are they? They are... they are M&S habanero hot wings, ridge cut. In the packet, it's sort of like a flame zebra print thing. Oh, they're pretty tasty. Excuse me. So how do we get back up? We got the geisha, is there a way to climb? Ah, yes, the shutter. Nope, that did nothing. One of these has got to lead upwards. There we go. Hey, catch up. We just followed one of your rules, lad. ABE. We explored and found something pretty handy. Is that a cobweb? Or is that dish soap? Oh, it's dish soap. Okay. There we are. Tweedledee and Tweedle, don't come anywhere near me, thanks. Right. Can't go up through there. So we have to go up through the middle one. He's gonna see us as we go through there, isn't it? So it gives you a glimpse. Gives you a glimpse of the room. It's like, ha! Good luck, motherfucker. Nope, turned around the moment we left the cover. Oh god, I'm just glad it's not the guy with the long arms. No! Why are you there now? No, get up! Get up, get up! Anyone else's butthole really tight? Avoid the broken crockery. How do we get out? What is this? Oh God. Right, so we need to get on the hooks, the meat hooks. Oh, they're somewhere in the other room. That's how we get to them, isn't it? Don't climb the plates, do we? No, there's got to be somewhere over there that we can climb. Oh God! Yeah, just really quickly dip into the thing in chat. So the reason why this discussion about Johnny Depp and Amber Heard has come back up again today and the pirates thing has been dragged into it is because Warner Brothers... So, Johnny Depp and Amber Heard had a really fucked up marriage. Neither of them were in a stable place and both of them did nasty things, but evidence has come to light to prove that Amber Heard did way worse than Johnny ever did, and a lot of Johnny's stuff can be attributed to trauma, grief, and being pushed by her. Like, so both of them like need to check themselves, but one of them is way worse, Amber Heard. Johnny was dropped from the Fantastic Beasts franchise by Warner Brothers because they didn't want to associate with him because of this controversy, and yet Warner Brothers have continued to employ Amber Heard, who today, as of this recording, began to shoot Aquaman 2 as the joint lead of Aquaman 2. So it's that whole controversy thing of like, the hypocrisy of Warner Brothers being like, we're not going to work with Johnny anymore, but we're still going to work with Amber. And, you know, it's like, that's bad. If you check the Aquaman 2 trend today, it's all people just saying, oh, Amber Heard's in it? Yeah, I think I'll pass. But also, people are now bringing up that Disney have dropped Johnny Depp from the Pirates franchise. They haven't. Captain Jack's just not going to be the main star of the next one, because here's the thing, we love the first movie like completely, and Lucy adores the trilogy completely, and we both enjoy On Stranger Tides. We both thought Salazar's Revenge / Dead Man Tells No Tales was shite, so neither of us are excited about the prospect of another Pirates film starring Captain Jack. Now a Pirates film starring other characters, like new characters, great. Captain Jack cameo, brilliant. Like no one is hankering for a Pirate 6 with Jack Sparrow. No one's like, I need it! As proved by the box office numbers of the previous two. So, it's a whole thing of like, you're all focusing on the wrong problem. The problem is Amber Heard and Warner Brothers' hypocrisy. That's the problem. Not Pirates. Stay focused. Do you know what I mean? Stay fucking focused. Anyway... Also, I'm not fussed about Johnny Depp no longer being part of Fantastic Beasts because I don't want to support that franchise anyway because the lead writer of it is a massive turf and an arsehole. So I'm much happier with him not being involved in it anymore, to be honest. Right, where do the hooks start? Hi, I'm Chris, I like movies, and I hate transphobes. So there we go. I hate transphobes and domestic abusers. Shit! No! Oh, I can't even see where the meat hooks begin. So the sausages are made out of children. Very possibly. Very possibly. What do I think could play Willy Wonka in the Warner Brothers Charlie and Chocolate prequel? Oh, they've already confirmed it's Timothy Chalamet. Will it be prequel to the original Willy Wonka film? Or I don't know. And personally, I don't care, but only because I'm like... Like, does it need to be told? Now, the only thing that's making me go... This could be a fun movie, is the fact that the... I just made a big mistake. Is the fact that the director's Paul King and the writer's Simon Farnaby, the guys who brought you... Paddington movie. So it's like, they've obviously got an angle. They have an angle. Okay. Okay. Like, maybe there's something to this Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, Willy Wonka thing. Because, like, these guys are bringing it to us. So, that's interesting. Oh, God. Taika Waititi's not involved. No, Taika Waititi's making Roald Dahl adaptations with Netflix. There's nothing new under the sun, my friends. If you notice, it goes quiet when they're like on your scent. I wonder, can we move this? No. Oh, I'm soapy. Right. Okay, so the hooks are coming out of somewhere over here, so can we climb somewhere that way? I don't know where we're meant to climb! Are we meant to climb? Find a vault. Games Vault TV. Someone do the command. Someone do the command. I don't think that's how this works. Also, you sneaky beaky. Is that an inaugural comment from our Twitch account? Because if so, I approve wholeheartedly. Look at this! It's almost like someone we spoke to has rubbed off on me. Look what I'm playing. This is good. It is very good. It's freaky and it's making me poo myself. Mods, whip out the command. Do the thing, and I shall praise ye. Thank you very much, Ketchup. Oh, Ketchup got there first. Beautiful boy. Thank you very much. Folks, brand new show, Games Vault. Our first full episode kickstarts this Friday. Chewy, thank you for the host. This Friday. For more information, go to the link there. nextside.tv/GamesVault. Give it a clicky, clicky, click, click. With a clicky, click. Who runs the Games Vault Twitch account? Same question as who watches The Watcher? I don't know. I don't know. Who is it on that end? Is it Lucas? Is it Leanne? Who's on that end? Where are we going? Good Omens Series 2 has been announced? Oh! What? Wait, what? What's it going to adapt? Is it going to adapt the book sequel that Neil Gaiman and Terry Pratchett were going to do but didn't get around to doing? Because if I say that, that'd be quite nifty. But if not... I don't understand. Then again, last night, we finished a rewatch of Hitchhiker's Guide. And what's odd about that, of course, is that the series ends on a cliffhanger and never got picked up. And Douglas Adams was like, was asked, why did you not do another series? And he said, because me and the Beeb fell out. They're like, oh, okay. What would it have been? Would it have been an adaptation of like more of the second book? Would it have been an adaptation of the second radio series? And he went, no, a completely new story, sort of borrowing from our unmade Doctor Who movie, Doctor Who and the Cricket Men. It's like, why? Because the script existed, the BBC had looked over it, and it was plausible to make. Lucas, lovely to meet you all. Just announced today our first interview guest this week's episode. Oh, brilliant. Right. So, regular viewers will know that we've got some previews of who our guests are on the Games Vault page. You've already checked it out. But yeah, so is everything out? Is it out on the social medias? I'm on Game Capture, so I can't do a window capture of the interweb on here. But yeah, folks, if you want everything, go to that link up above once again. Hang on, I'm doing the wrong thing. Mods, you're smart. Do the Games Vault shout out. Thank you, Cheery. So, if you all follow that link, you get to the main hub page. You can find all of our socials down at the bottom. So you can follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, etc., etc. But also, you can sign up to the newsletter, which means you get alerts and chances to find out about competitions before other people do. So, hop to it, you lot. How is it there today, Lucas? Because it's warm as balls here today. Ooh, and I've got a burp trap. How am I supposed to get up? I'm really confused. I'm genuinely confused as to where I'm meant to go. Do I climb these shelves? That was just a guess. I'm not even kidding. That was a guess. And I'm dead. But now we know what to do. AC's working. Okay, the AC's keeping you cool. I'm not dead. Is there more footed ball? Chewie's our resident football explainer. Chewie, is there more football?
And that's why heaven is full of angels.
Thank you so much for the host. No, okay, we can't jump straight for the hook. We can cling on like this. England, Germany. Well, that's not going to cause some kind of ruckus on social media, is it? That's not going to unleash a bunch of xenophobes on social media. Oh. Oh, no, I don't like this. They know I'm here. They're aware of my presence. Can they turn the switch off? No. Ooh. Wait, is that the second one or is there a third? They can grab me there. Right, so I need to get down. Oh my god, this is terrifying. This is the worst thing to play on an afternoon. I'm shitting my pants. I'm going to get tons of people screaming it's coming home. Exactly. As long as I'm having fun. Fair enough. Run! They're too quick. Right, how do we get out then? What's the trick? What's the trick? Oh my god! Oh! Okay. My, oh look, if you press forward, she does a little run in the air. My heart rate is increasing like crazy. Who else is feeling tense? This is horrifying. Is that the last of the chefs? Have we escaped the chefs? We've escaped the chefs. There's the trophy. Okay. Oh my god.
I'm pooping myself.
But you knew that. When you lay down. I'm not pooping myself. Or am I? I'm not. Yet. So where are we now? Oh, was that another one of those leeches? A leech just slid off the pipe. Oh, we're on the outside of the ship! Can we get some Brucies, please? If you think that was a good game, well played, whip out your Brucies. Okay, where are we going?
Oh. Thank you, Ian. Some prideful Brucies. We love to see it. The Konami code doesn't work here, Ian. Other Ian? Several Ians? There are giant homunculoids boarding this ship from another ship. What is happening? So we're far out at sea then. What is the plot? No one tell me, no spoilers. Like, what is this? Like, what is this about? I'm really confused. Like, what is it? What is it? What are this? This is beautiful though, isn't it? Look at it. Stuart with your wall of Brucies, much appreciated. By the way, guys, if you type in command Linktree, you can find out where all of my stuff is. I need to add the Games Vault stuff on there itself, but for now, you could use the Games Vault prompt to find out everything you need to know about that one. Just a heads up, just a reminder, that's another thing that changed the other day. Also, have the Streamlabs things been coming through? They have. Oh, in fact, there you go. There's Linktree. Thank you, Ian. A wall of dunes. Brilliant. That's got to be Mel's, right? Mel's has got to create them, surely. Who are these large homunculoids? Why do they all look like me queuing up to get into the local Mackies? You can't do that yet. And also, it's cheaper and to get just eat. Just saying. Prime Mel. Quality Mel.
Yes.
Wait, what? What? What the deuce? I know what you mean, Chew, but it's just in case people got confused.
Her name is Melula.
Oh, mods can do shout-outs, Cockle. A wall of Orville. A Wallville! Okay, this is creepy. So, we know the ship is loading up with these really, like, large monster men and women. And we know that children have been captured and served up as meat. What is happening? That one's got, like, a clown face. Oh, they're wearing masks! And there's the geisha! There's the geisha we had the nightmare about! Okay, I'm not gonna lie, when I first started playing this game, I was like, okay, so it's a creepy concept game, walkthrough stuff, it is unnerving, and disturbing in its art style, and really creepy, and no, turns out there's some kind of story happening here. Why are all the large, like, fat cannibals, because let's assume that they're all cannibals, because they're coming here to the ship where the chef's preparing children to eat, why are the fat cannibals wearing, like, we happy for you smiley face masks? And who is this geisha? What is going on? Really better not draw attention to ourselves. Yeah, not all of them are wearing masks, but some of them are. Like, flat face, flat face, flat face. But that one up ahead's wearing a mask. What's going on? In fact, the one wearing a mask just went through here. And they're just eating raw meat. Meanwhile, in the chat, someone started a poll. Who's your favourite TV chef? Delia Smith, Gordon Ramsay, Nigella Lawson, Jamie Oliver, Nadia Hussein. For me personally, I'm a Nigella guy. And not for the obvious reasons. But the obvious reasons don't hurt. It's giving me very Spirited Away vibes. Yes! Now you've pointed out there's a bit of a Ghibli. Or Ghibli. If you're nasty. Vibe. Oh, this is horrible. Anyone who has played this or seen a playthrough. Are we? Oh! We died. Are we near the end? I had a feeling it was longer. I have a feeling it is longer. No! How the hell do I get around that? How the hell do I get around that? Seems like no matter what, it sees me. Oh, it's my least favorite thing in the world. It's a continuous chase sequence. Oh god, is anyone else freaking the hell out? Because I'm freaking the hell out. Imagine the expressions I'm pulling right now. Also, is anyone eating lunch? Follow-up question. Has anyone given up on lunch? That's a drawing of a child. Is that a hole in the wall? Yes. Ramsay wins. A gnome folk that isn't running away. What was that about? Oh. Am I helping it get its sock? I get it, you want to climb, buddy, but I don't know what... Am I meant to throw it at the sock? Because it's... the aim is suggesting otherwise. I just feel really bad now. Just throwing this little gnome dude around. It was close, right? Okay, maybe it's not that. No, it is. He keeps reaching up. Is this going to be the thing that stumps us? We're here for like 6 hours. So look around. What we got? Okay, I'm really confused. Right, so let's watch the gnome, see what he does. So he scrambles over here. Does he follow us? He does. Is it then? Okay, does anyone have any idea what we're doing here? Because I am actually completely stumped. Do we need to get on the table? Good question. If we get on the table, he's going to see us. Oh, you're suggesting we might have to get on it and leg it. No! Oh, God. Okay. Yep, I can see now we have to get to... make sure that lamp's lit, shall we? Oh, that was the worst thing ever. Yeah, this is incidental. The gnome thing's incidental. Oh, God. We ready? We ready? A lot of people have tuned out, like, nope. Oh, that was the worst thing ever. I hated it, I hated it, I hated it. This game is amazing. Oh! Stuart, thank you very much for the tip! Bless your eyes! Thank you very much, I appreciate it. Real footage of me eating Domino's. Yeah. Not even my favourite pizza option, but it just, you know, it hits a spot. Stuart, that was very kind. Could we get some OMS out for Stuart, please? That was very, very sweet, man. Oh, she got stuck behind the ramp.
Don't need that, I'll tell you that for now.
Maybe there's a peach branch called Papa Yonks. A Papa John's has opened near us recently. I'm wondering whether we're adventurous enough to give it a go, because I've not had it in years, and when we did have it, it was like, eh, you know? They see it like sort of dominoes. It's one of those things where you need to get it sort of once in a million years, because otherwise it's a bit of a waste of money in terms of what you're getting for the amount. You know, like when your local pizza joint does like a large pizza for like $6.99. Okay, that was horrifying. Whereas a Domino's is, like, you know, a large piece of, like, $12.99 or whatever, and it's just like, okay. Like, am I paying for the pizza or am I paying for the brand? You know what I mean? Get up! No! my god. Straight up inhaled. What, are you eating Dominoes or that reaction?
Jesus. Jesus Christ, no.
Okay, so the trick here is to run back, let him get derailed, and then get around him. Okay. Both. Ugh. Oh, it was horrifying. Geisha statue! Oh, I thought there was a gap in there. Maybe there is. I have to explore to find out.
No.
Don't want any of this. Don't want any of this. It's the worst thing ever. So it's not the worst thing ever, it's pretty great, but like, ugh. Sorry, I'm just getting a bunch of alerts. What? Is it, what on earth? What? No, go away. Right, okay. Moving on. Right, so, when they come out the lift, leg it, cabinet underneath it. Oh, but there's a geisha statue we're going to miss. I guess we just missed that statue. It's just something we can't get yet. Don't close the door. There's a geisha statue I want to get. And that's how we're gonna get it. So we need to go that way. Hang on. Forgetting my buttons. Can I jump on that? No. So I guess that's a geisha statue you can't get then? I guess there's a geisha statue you can't get. Okay. Interesting. Huh. Oh, God. Okay. Where do I go? Can we leave? No. Okay. For a moment, I thought we weren't going to show up in the reflection. I was like, what are you getting at, game? It's got to be something we can throw at something, right? It has to be. Well, obviously not that. Read the music box. You ready? Secret room? What? What on earth? It's a secret bloody room. Go.
Progression.
Oh God. That's the one with the mask on. Is that gnome trying to make him piss himself by putting his hand in a bucket of water? Can we join in? No, but we gave it a hug. Gnaughty gnome. Ha! Yes! Yes, Stuart, I approve. Oh, good Lord. Oh, sweet Jesus and all who sail in him. Don't get stuck, little one! No! Ah! Didn't make the jump or the grab. Now we know what we're in for. I guess the gnome thing is just for comedy, like giving them a hug must just be like a little, go on, give them a cuddle. Oh God. Noises they make as well.
No!
Oh God. Are we ready? It really is a case of, like, every second counts, isn't it? No! God. Oh! My heart is racing. That is mad. Oh, no, she's hungry. Last time we ate a rat that was alive. Look, there's a whale with a similar mouth to the thingy. It looks like a ship. It's got a blowhole, but steam's coming out of the blowhole. Come on, gotta find some food. Power on, power on. We have to eat something like that's living, aren't we? We have to like eat a gnome or something. Sausage. There's a sausage. The gnomes have sausage. Let's eat a sausage. Thank you. That was horrifying. And I was not a fan. Also, what the hell was that white square on the screen just then? Did you see that? Bit weird. We killed a gnome. There's the geisha. Oh. Wants us to go that way, which means there's probably something to find over here. Yep. Abe! Precisely, ketchup. Precisely, my love. Okay, so logic dictates we want to get in the elevator. Anyone who's seen this before, are we close to the end? Yes. Would you say this playthrough close?
The guest area is complete.
That was awful. I loved it. Horrifying. I was going to stream for 2 hours, but if we were, say, like, a bit away from it, like, for example, Ian, without looking, if you've already seen it, Ian, do us a favour, look up just, like, roughly how long is left in terms of segments. We've completed today 2 segments of the story. In terms of the trophies, like, marking out the plot. If there was, like, one more, if there was, like, 2 more, I'd say let's pick this up tomorrow, but if there's like 1 more, it's like,
let's go.
Do you know what I mean? Oof, God, this is nasty. nasty. This is nasty shit.
Ugh.
I have a feeling that the picture's painting a bit more of a picture than we're allowing. Because we're now in like a guest quarter. Well, this is the nicest looking part of the ship we've been in. There's an awful lot of mannequins, though. Okay, so we need a key. It's probably going to be up here, isn't it? Very unfortunate events with all the eyes. Creepy sin. I'm just wondering if there's something I could find up there. So the moment she's aware of our existence, she psychic chokes us out of being alive. So once again, the carpet's playing an important role. Can we sneak past her? Right, there's a... Okay, where's the key? We have a very prominent jar, which would suggest perhaps the key is being kept in there, so we need to break it. But then we need to hide. Well, we've got the bed, so we can hide under the bed. Like how deathly quiet things have just gotten. Does that mean we've got all the geisha statues? I'm super tense. How are you guys feeling? Yeah, Moderna winded me for a few hours as well. No! So what does she do to us? Would we be like choked to death or... I'm freaking out. Like, this is... this is terrifying. Okay. A few more of the mannequins have her exact silhouette now. Can we pull that beam off? Stuart! Amazon currently with free delivery, one left in stock. Really? Oh, my dude! That's very kind! Bless you, man! That is super sweet! Thank you! Remind me at the end of the stream. Oh, my dude, thank you so much! That is, I mean, you've done way too much already, so stop. But that is, mate, for a playthrough for everyone to enjoy, I'm not going to say no to that. Thank you so much, man. Tell you what, hang on. So hang on, tell you what. So what was it? Little Nightmares 2 on Amazon, yeah? Little Nightmares... 2. 1 left in stock, PlayStation 4. You think it's okay, Steam? What? You think it's on Steam? I can't play Steam, Cockle. I can't play Steam, unfortunately. I have to play it on PlayStation. Hang on. Yeah. 1 second, folks. One second. Okay, we'll do it now so it's not delaying it after. But what I may do, Stuart, is if it's on PlayStation Network, I might buy it from there. So we've got it digitally. Or physically, but I'll wait till after this so we can carry on with the playthrough. I don't want to delay too much. But if we do buy it digitally, if there's a price difference, I'll put the money towards something in the streams, like Fortnite stuff or something like that. Does that sound alright? Sorry, your internet died. Can't handle me watching you stream and Googling. Right, hang on. Oof. No worries, man. Thank you for it. That is very kind of you. What the hell are we meant to do? What the hell are we meant to do? Is there something we need to find that goes on here? Oh no, it's this. Oh god, I just realized it's a mirror. This is a boss fight, isn't it? Very good point, and she's broken all the other mirrors. She can't look in the mirrors. This is Gorgon rules. It's like the doorways. She got to me first. Ah, so you've got to get to it with a certain amount of time. Did you see my head start to twist as she lifted us up? This is horrifying. This is like the worst thing ever, and I love it. Okay, here we go. God, it's really close, isn't it? So the next one was here, and this is where she fakes us out a little bit, flies around us. Front of camera.
Yuck, sack!
Far end. Thank you for the cheers, my lovely! Oof. God, here we go. Thank you so much for the bit, Stuart. That's very kind. Guys, can we give some alms for Stuart, please? Being a massive, generous... Generous... Something that rhymes with generous. No! She got too close. Right, she comes from the bottom corner. She comes from the bottom corner. Oh! Did it bring up a yonk sack to ease the tension? Attention easing Yonksack. Works when you give it a little tickle. Okay, so when we get to that one, she comes from the bottom right corner. I'm kind of hoping that's the last one. I love in this game you have to die a few times to sort of learn what horrors await you should you fail. So if there's a pattern, bottom right corner. Get up, little one. Come on. The mirror shattered. Oh no, we're hungry, and there's a woman on the floor. Is it implying we eat the woman or the mask?
Yonksack!
Thanks for the gesture. We are monster now? Oh, Tipsy. For starters, mods, could we please get a shout out for Tipsy for being one of the most positive and uplifting streamers on this entire platform ever? But secondly, Stuart in chat gifted me the money to buy number two so we could play it. So we will be playing it very soon. So thank you for the shout out there. I don't handle spooky very well. This is freaking me out. I'm loving it. I got to interview the CEO of the developers, Tarsia Studios, the other day, and... Oof. What is happening? What are we? Are we the little nightmare? Bless you, Tipsy, hey. If we could bring some entertainment, worth it. Ian, thank you so much for the shout out for Tipsy Tune. Oh my god. Why do some of them have We Happy Few masks on? It's really creepy. I'm controlling this, by the way. Just the walking. Oh. The power is intoxicating. The morality is questionable. It's like being Jeffrey Bezos. Right. Oh god. But I'm sure this character pays their taxes. Where are we going? Into the light, it's always a good sign. We docked?
The ladies' quarter. A ladies' court shoe.
What is happening? Why is happening? All the little gnomes, of which we ate some. Because of course we did. Why did we eat? I'd stand up and do the Citizen Kane thing, but I am literally wearing boxes, so it's not going to happen. But what I will do is fill the chat with Brucey's. Holy shit. Holy shit. Holy shit. That had an atmosphere and a half. Oh my god. So when I interviewed... Andreas Johnson, CEO of the studios of the week for Games Vault. Again, if you want more information on the show and you want to catch the first full episode this Friday, there's the E3 special up there available to watch right now. When I interviewed Andreas Johnson, I knew of the games in as much as I did my research. Normally when I interview a guest, I do a bunch of research beforehand so that when we get there, they're comfortable knowing the person talking to them isn't just pulling questions out their arse and hoping for the best. And with this case, I had to hold off a little bit because, like, I knew what I knew of Little Nightmares from the outside, but I still knew I wanted to play it at some point. So I tried not to delve too deep into it. So I've seen some of the designs for number two, and I've seen some of the designs for this one. I've watched some playthroughs of this one, and I kind of left it at that to keep myself in suspense. I'm so glad I played this one. I did. Oh my god. I just want to get in touch with them again and be like, dude, by the way, I finally played Little Nightmares myself. I fucking loved it. And also, it was quite short. We finished it in less than... I think just over 4 hours total playtime. I guarantee there'll be things that we need to find that we didn't find. There absolutely will be. I wonder, can we... No, you know, I'm not going to skip the credits. I'm going to let them sit. Stuart, fill in all the bits and subs. Thank you very much, man. let me see. If the donation has come through my PayPal already, then we might buy the digital copy tonight, and then we'll do a big damn play next week, maybe? For number two? Well, like I said, Stuart, if there's a money difference between the PlayStation Store version and the physical copy, then I'll make up the difference by putting the... what do you call it? The money into, like... I'm just keeping it in the PlayStation Store or putting it into, like, Fortnite or something, the few quid, if that's okay with you. Yeah, it came through on my PayPal, so I could pay for my PayPal. What do the bits actually do? So bits are like a tip. When you got all your bits, you were either gifted some when you signed up or you paid for them. And essentially, like, they're like... They're pennies. They're like a little chiss. Like 100 bits, I think, is like about, with tax, it's like 70p. So it's sort of like a, hey, it's a little tip. Thank you very much. So, yeah, so you tip me like £1.50. So that's very sweet of you. Thank you very much. Considering you've also paid for a bloody game for us to play. You swine. You Schweinhund. This was gorgeous. What did you guys think? Those who watched me play through this, who'd never seen it before... What leapt out at you? What was your favourite thing about it? For those who have seen this or played this before and were just watching from our reactions, what did you enjoy? Because I think I'm going to have a tough time going back and looking at my face in the highlights that Ian cut up. Because it was during those really gross tense moments where large homunculoid customers were crawling after me. So, The game began with the nightmare of that geisha, and then we found the statues everywhere and smashed them up. When we defeated her, we ate her flesh and seemed to get, like, her power, as it were, of draining people's life or psychically killing them. We'll never forget about Kitchen Grease Man and his bloody brother. The Grease Brothers. I will never forget the feeling we got when we first spotted the janitor guy. So how many monsters did we have then? We had the janitor dude with the long arms and the short body and this clacking jaw. That was freaky. We had him. We had the chefs. We had the myriad of gigantic customers. The leeches, of course! They were the villains of the first section, the bloody leeches. Which is the little nightmares villain you most scared of? The janitor, the twin chefs, the lady, the leeches, or the shoe monster? The shoe monster? Oh, the thing in the shoes. Oh, God, yeah, the Star Wars trash compactor thing. I think for me, the one that freaked me out the most was probably the janitor. It was the way he ground his teeth. The other way, it was just like... He's like, what are you doing, mate? No, thank you. Don't need that in my life. Don't need that in my life. I have other things to do. Please stop clacking your teeth. And those just big arms. And the fact that they're not Mr. Tickle, like tendril arms. The fact they've got an elbow joint and a wrist joint. It's like, ooh, they look so jagged. Blah. Blah. Oh, no, no. No, didn't need that. Well, I do, you know what? I do, is Little Nightmares too longer? Because I'm wondering, because I do enjoy it when we have a nice short on swift big damn play. Oh, Games Vault ramping up the promotion on the socials. Let's see, shall we? Doo-doo, let's get the promotion on the go. There we go. So as Ian's pointed out, there were three main monsters. Well, four, because two of them were twins, but I know what you mean. And then the others are the leeches and the thing in the shoes. That was horrifying. The thing in the shoes was freaking weird, but it just reminded me of Star Wars, which makes me happy inside. I don't want to interrupt the music. It's just pretty sweet. Boom, 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 boom. Boom, 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 boom. Bump, bump, pee bump, bumps. Can you hear my lady lumps? It's definitely one of those games you think you know. I thought it was running through something with the chefs. I had no idea about the janitor or the lady or the ship story. What was that Medusa cannon where it turned the children? Oh, yeah, the eye above the door that turned us into stone. That was horrifying. Little Nightmares 2 is about half and a half hours. What? Is about half and a half hours. What do you mean, Ian? Little Nightmares is using Pochion fonts. Yeah, bloody is. 5.5 hours. Oh, so it'd be like three big damn play kind of thingy. Okay. Probably three big damn play chapters. Little Nightmares. So obviously this kid that we played was purposeful. Like it knew what would happen if we killed the geisha lady. Or did it just eat them out of desperation? Oh. Am I in control of this, or... No, it's a cutscene. Thank you for playing. Thank you for having me, terrifying game. So we're sat outside a door with a creepy, creepy eye, and presumably this is where the ship dropped us off. Do we go in there and go down to Rapture? Was this all a Bioshock spin-off the whole time? Everybody on there was a... what are they called in Bioshock? What was everyone called? When they're all screwed up by the chemicals and ting. Resume game. Not sure how that works. Chapter section. So I guess there's a reason to go back in and try and platinum or find little collectible levels if you've missed them. God, this was freaky. This was really, really freaky. The janitor wins. So yeah, so prison stuff. Hang on, can you go down? Oh! Oh, is that the DLC? Huh. Oh, no. Oh, no, 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 no. There's plenty to find and unlock still. Good lord. Sweet baby Jesus, I'm glad that was not in the game. There's plenty still to find and unlock. Okay, so let's check the trophies we got. The Depths, the Hideaway, the Residence. Yes, this is the DLC. So today we got Highly Sprung, you jump even higher if you knew what slept there. The Chefs Will Miss You. Little Fox Among Hungry Wolves. Little Vandal, Little Beast, the Moor will punish you at the feast. Okay. And a storm is coming. That coat should come in useful. Kindness will be your undoing. I bet that's something to do with that gnome if we manage to make the trick work. Okay, so we have DLC for this game. That I did not entirely know. So let's see how much the DLC is, shall we? Oh, bloody thing's broken. What are you doing? Go back. That's something to do with this new controller, the keypad, the touch bar. Likes to have a field day. Alright, let's have a look how much the DLC is, shall we? Because we could do that before we move on to number two. The Residence, the Hideaway, Fox Mask, the Depths. Others lead the escape, but the kids are known as the Depths of the Okay. It's like a whole Secrets of the Moor expansion. So is this all three of them together? Residence, Hideaway, and Depths. If they're all in here... Yes! Okay, yeah, this is all three by the look of it. Unveil all the secrets of the Moor in a parallel escape story where you play as the runaway kid, another prisoner looking for a way out of this place of misfortune. On his journey, the kid will explore the depths of the Hideaway in another part of the Moor, offering a different perspective on Six's adventures as well as new challenges to overcome. Get Little Nightmares, Secrets of the Moor, and enjoy this. Okay, so this is all three of them, which is cheaper. To play them all would be like £10 summit, buy them individually, or £7.99. So let's add it to the cart because... Stuart, thank you very much for your donation. Thank you very, very much for your donation because you donated, what was it, 28 schmeckles and chucked in a cheer and a bit. So, oh, a janitor theme. You get a theme for your desktop. Ooh. Because you chucked in 28 schmeckles. Then if we head back... And it'll work on the PS5 too. So it's $24.99. So basically, mate, you've put money toward Little Nightmares 2. What are the add-ons for it then? Little Nightmares 2 and the DLC for T'other. Oh, hang on. Deluxe Edition is $26.24. What's the Deluxe Edition? It's on sale at the moment. What's the Deluxe Edition? This product entitles you to both the digital PS4 version and the digital PS5 version of the game. Little Nightmares 2 full game, the Gnome's Attic DLC, full digital soundtrack, the art of Little Nightmares, a theme and 6 avatars. Mate, come on. There's a sale on right now. $26.24 for the complete deluxe digital version. Add to cart. It's like quid something more than... What on earth? So, go to cart. What have we got in the cart? Stuart, thank you very, very much, my friend. That is very much appreciated. I'm going to have to cover up the screen here. I'm going to have to have my PayPal account, so I'll do that now. Or I could just pair my card account and put it into my account from my PayPal. I'll do that. Order and pay. Would you look at that? Boom. Boom. A boom. Oh, I guess there's stuff in game. I'm absolutely downloading the artwork. Are you kidding me? I want to see the artwork. And the soundtrack, because why not? Stuart, thank you so very much. So, for those who are watching this after the fact, coming up probably this weekend, because I'm busy with Games Vault work for the rest of the week now, but coming up this weekend, we will continue the original Little Nightmares one more time with the DLC packs, see if we can play them all in one sitting. Look at that. Oh, look at that. And thanks to the wonderful Stuart, we'll be playing the DLC. And we will be playing the Little Nightmares 2 in the weeks afterwards. Stuart, thank you very much. Very, very kind, man. I really do appreciate it. Om's out for Stuart, folks. That's it for today. Maybe back at some point later in the week, probably Friday night. If you're watching this live, two things. Thank you. First off, and secondly, do not forget Games Vault this week, Saturday. If you head to this page, you'll never miss it. Our first full episode with voice actor Sean Chiplock as our guest is going out this Friday. So check it out, nextside.tv/gamesvault. You can also find it on YouTube, folks. In fact, the more subscribers we get, the more we show up in the algorithm for the search bar. So hurry up and subscribe if you can. You can do it through that link I've just posted in chat. If you are watching this on YouTube or as a subscriber after the live broadcast, then hi, I'm Chris. This is the past, you're in the future, but you could have made this your present. Come and give us a follow, twitch.tv/officialcdj to tune in live. The live folks who are watching right now, let's go over and raid. What should we raid? Oh, the wonderful Cactus Nax is playing a spooky game, Phasmophobia. We'll go over and praise that Welsh god and his wonderfulness. And I will catch you all on the Discord if you're a subscriber. See you very, 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 very soon. Stuart, thank you very much, man. clicky, clicky wink. That was creepy. Speaking of creepy, phasmophobia time. Bye!